Welcome everybody, you're joining us on a hot Sunday night. You are with the Mega 64 boys. We're not going to be bogged down by a bunch of jibber jabber and nonsense.
No, it's called the bullshit night.
Right. So we're not going to grind to any halts just for some bullshit reason.
Why would we?
That doesn't have a point. We're on point tonight. Welcome. We're coming right off our biggest event of the year, Game Days at Disneyland. Thank you, everybody. If you came out and joined us, thank you. If you didn't come out and you didn't join us, thank you, too, because it was a perfect event.
Yeah. You would have ruined it.
Yeah. It was the perfect amount of people.
Yeah, one less person, one more person might have thrown the balance off.
Mm-hmm.
It was pure chemistry at Game Days this year. And I don't use that word lightly. Everybody had sex with each other. Confirmed.
Congratulations.
That's what chemistry means.
Whoa.
No more V's in our club.
Except me. I'm still a V.
Oh, yeah?
Whoa, you carry that card?
I'm the only person who did not lose it.
That's pretty strong and Christian of you.
Who didn't lose it at Game Days. I am strong and Christian. I'm glad you bring that up.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Tangent. Cheers. Side note.
Yeah.
Side note.
Yeah,
have you seen the video?
Cheers. Good job.
My sister. Cheers to being Christian.
Cheers to being Christian.
I saw a video today. We're talking video games. We're talking Twisted Metal. This is the number one video game podcast on the internet. Let's bring it back to our original discussion. Mm-hmm. Game Days was this past weekend. What did you guys think of Game Days?
You know, it started off the first day, which people saw last week's podcast of the panel, which I thought went really well.
Mm-hmm.
I thought it was really cool. The Game Grumps came out. They took time out of their schedule to do that with us. We didn't pay them. They just did it because they're friends of ours.
Shoots out to the Game Grumps.
Shoots out.
Well, they lost their virginity, so they got paid.
And finally.
They got paid in.
I know Aaron's been waiting.
Yeah. You know what? The only bummer to me, honestly, was that podcast went up and the comments were so negative about them. That was like, man, these guys did us a favor, and they just got shit on real bad for that. But
I didn't read the comments.
Shake it off.
So what was the worst comment?
I like T-Swift.
Shake it off.
What was the worst comment?
I don't want to say it because it was real bad.
Why? You should say it real loud. You wrote it.
But they.
Is it racial?
Yeah.
Is it?
It wasn't racial.
Call them honkies?
No, they didn't do that.
That'd be fucked up.
It was just all fucked up stuff, and it's like, man, these guys just came out and just did us a favor, but whatever. I mean, like. I was always embarrassed because, like, our fans are cooler than this. Like, what's happening? What are they doing? Like,
but the people that comment on YouTube probably aren't the people that came out.
No,
to the
and
event.
The people at the event watching. Were stoked they were there and it's super cool of them. So I'm not talking about those people.
I just always, you know, I don't care what YouTube comments say. Ever since I read the comment, I was looking at that video of Nazi Germany and this dude left a comment that was like, Hitler was an idiot because he liked Italians and he aligned himself with Italians. And it was a comment on YouTube. Saying Hitler wasn't racist enough. And it kind of all clicked to me, like, yeah, the comments on YouTube are fucking whack.
Yeah.
I don't think I should put much stock into what these say.
I don't.
So like I said, no stupid tangents this week.
Right, cut the bullshit week.
Cut the bullshit. Game Days. Thank you to Game Grumps for coming out. We really appreciate
it. Definitely.
Whether our fans liked you or
not. No, they liked you in person.
Everybody who went to Game Days had a great time.
Yeah.
I asked every single attendee, personally, not really. But if I did, they would have all said they had a great time.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I could tell from the vibes in the room that Game Grumps did well.
I was met with nothing but smiles, man.
I haven't heard anything negative to come out of
and
it.
And you know,
honestly, yeah.
No, I was going to say, we showed a new video that's going to come out tomorrow, actually. And
unless you're watching this on Tuesday, then it came out yesterday.
And you know what I'm talking about. The reaction was very, very positive.
It was.
And I'm going to say now, before you watch it, that was all Rocco.
Yeah.
If you hate it, that is Rocco's fault.
He really talked about that in depth before we showed it at the
Well, I wanted to be, because we saw it for the first time.
No one, well, yeah, all of us saw it for the first time. He made it very clear, like, if it's shit, blame me.
Like, if you like it, it's my, whatever.
But it there was no way it was going to be shit, so he shouldn't have done that.
No, whatever, go for it.
It was good.
He is.
I was very happy with it.
Okay. A god.
Yeah, he's an editing
he
god.
He is a
guys.
God. Can we just take a moment and talk about how Rocco's a god?
Sure. Yeah. Can we hold hands?
No.
No. All
right.
He's a god.
Okay.
What kind of god?
That's
it's like a Roman god. He's not just like an all-seeing, all-powerful god.
But he's strong.
He's like a god. You know how Bacchus is the god of wine? We've talked about that many times.
We have.
Many times.
Cheers.
Hail Bacchus with my lean.
Hail Bacchus.
I think in modern times, Bacchus can be known as the god of lean.
Yeah.
And Sizzrup.
Yeah.
I think Rocco is the god of making shit videos fun to watch. And that's a lot.
I agree.
And yeah. I'm not even saying that video was shit, but I've seen
in general.
That's his most powerful skill.
Mm-hmm. He can do that. He takes nothing and turns it into something. Mm-hmm. So yes.
Rocco editing when it's just him by himself, you will see a video the day before and then the next day that are completely different,
but it's the same.
It's like a clay that he molds.
It's crazy.
It is.
He's very
impressive.
He's a maestro.
Mm-hmm.
And the more exhausted he is and the less sleep he gets, the weirder and funnier the video turns out to be. So, interesting.
He drinks a lot of Monster Energy drinks,
too. About that.
So who's really responsible if the movie's that good?
The devil.
Who do we think?
The devil.
Hail Bacchus.
Could it be Bacchus? I don't know.
Changing my answer. Rocco is the god of the devil.
That's good.
Wow! That's fucking a cool thing to be. That sounds like a place in Destiny that you'd have to go find, like you'd have to go fight a monster.
That's too clever.
It's the god of the devil. Yeah. He's like the last boss.
Are we all gods, or is just Rocco god tier?
I'm C.
Oh, you want to get like meta?
I would like to be the god of fuck. Like that Marilyn
I'm sure
Manson
you would.
Song?
You are? Sure.
Oh, you are. Really? Oh,
wow.
Shouts out, dude.
Wow.
Anyways, no bullshit cast.
No tangents. The second day, the day at Disneyland, I thought was so much fun. We had an insane turnout.
Yeah,
enough time in that day.
It really wasn't
for all the like hanging out and all the people to see.
Yeah, it was crazy.
I had to leave a little bit early that day. I bought some shoes specifically for game days, and they were half a size too small.
Oh, is that what you left? I didn't say goodbye to you. That's what happened.
I think you left before I did.
No, I was there.
I didn't see you then. But yeah my feet
we
were...
We left at like 9.
Yeah. I left at like 10, I think.
My feet
we had
were
to drive back.
Killing me. They were brand new shoes, and on the way back to the tram, the heel started breaking off.
What the fuck?
And
really?
They were 2 days old and super uncomfortable. I was so fucking pissed off, truth be told, at the end of game days. It was like my feet hurt, my brand new shoes are breaking. No. I just want to be fucking home.
Wow, it sucks.
But I took them back. Shots out to the van store. They exchanged them. They're not supposed to do that.
Yeah. But did you say like, hey, what the fuck? These are 2 days old.
I did. And I said exactly that. And I said I wore them. I didn't go skating or running. I was just walking around and I felt like there was something stuck in the heel. And I looked down, the heel's coming off. And this girl was like, that looks like a defective shoe. You want to exchange them? And I was like, yes. She's like, what size? And I was like, yeah.
New size.
That's cool. So, no tangents.
No tangents.
Shouts out to Vans.
No, I thought it was really cool. I had not seen the new Thunder Mountain until game days. That was rad.
The new Thunder Mountain is cool.
Very impressed with
that. The biggest thing they changed that I noticed was the volcano when you get to the top of the mountain and all the mine up there. It's a fully fleshed out like Disney experience now.
Yeah. Oh,
lights
wow.
and smoke and special effects.
And
it's really cool.
The cave starts like falling down you and smoke goes everywhere. It was really cool.
Oh, that's
cool. It was really neat.
That's cool.
And it was really smooth. Everyone said how smooth it was, and they were not lying. It was very smooth.
Yeah. Was it not smooth before?
It was not that smooth. It was like,
you know what?
Gliding.
People need to shut up about roller coasters being bumpy. It's a freaking roller coaster.
Yeah.
It's a mine cart attached to a rail system that was built to piss you off. And shake you around.
To piss you off.
That's what a roller coaster... They're supposed to scare you.
Supposed to make you fun.
They're supposed to make you feel like you're going to fly out at any moment.
True.
So when people ride a roller coaster, they get off, they're like, oh, that was bumpy. Oh my God, go home.
This is the first time I've been on the new Matterhorn carts.
Oh yeah.
And they were a lot nicer.
They were not nicer.
Well, I don't have a boner poking me in the back.
Yeah.
I hate it.
Yeah. I think that's a big improvement is like you get your own seat now. So it's not less bumpy. I don't think the track has changed at all, but you're cushioned and you can hold on better.
And yeah, you're not. I never will forget seeing like that poor like 13-year-old guy who was in between his mom's legs. Like you don't want to be there.
Yeah, mom goes in between my legs.
You don't want to be there.
That's great.
That's not a fun ride experience.
But that's a great ride to take a girl on. So there goes that.
You still got that dark part where you're climbing up and nobody can see anything.
Yeah,
that
just
happens.
And do what?
Just secret handshake.
Yeah.
Do a handshake.
Maybe she could do it. Or reach over. It depends on who's in front, who's behind.
Uh-huh. Eric, it depends.
Dude.
Use your fucking brain, man.
All right. It all depends. So,
no, but I thought the has Rocco released a castle picture yet? Has that been?
I don't know. I've been waiting.
I got that picture. We'll put it up this week. Yeah, definitely.
I want to see it. Do you have a number?
I counted in the picture. I want to say 240 people. Yeah.
Whoa.
Really?
In the picture. But I know for a fact the picture did not have everybody who was in attendance.
It was so fucking big.
We filled as many people as we could, but I could see groups off to the side, and I could see groups who waited around.
Just gave up. They're like, I don't want to fucking stand here.
Also, I don't blame them. It was situated, people were in the picture they weren't seen. Like,
yeah.
I was with people, because it kind of took a while. And they were getting, like, smashed because they were trying to lay down, and it was...
Well, it was 240 people posing for a picture, so...
Yeah.
When you think about it like that, it was awesome, and it took no time
at all. I also know a ton of people who were like, oh, I missed the picture, or... We got a little late, so they took off after we went there. So, you know, whatever. It was still an awesome, awesome turnout. It was a ton of fun. It was crazy going to, like, Space Mountain, and the line was... 30 minutes, and by the time our whole group was in there, it was now 90 minutes. Like, damn. We had that much of impact on Disneyland wait times.
Since I didn't go on Space Mountain.
What'd you do? It was Ghost Galaxy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, it's stupid.
Hey, Disneyland, take out Ghost Galaxy.
It was like Dead Space. People described it to me as being...
No.
No.
Not at all.
No.
Who described it like that?
I don't know. Someone at Game Day.
Give me a name.
I don't know. I don't remember.
Give me
a name.
If you described Space Mountain as Dead Space.
They're watching right now. You know they are because they went to Game Days.
What? Are you kidding me?
Hey, I just smiled and said, yeah, man.
I'm trying to think in any way how Dead Space and Space Mountain Ghost Galaxies overlaps. In even the smallest way. They're both in space.
Yeah, that would be it.
They're both in space.
Dead Space Mountain Ghost Galaxy.
Doesn't a flame face chase you around?
Yeah.
No. He shows up like at the beginning, and then he like turns into stars. I remember in the past, like a flaming ghost hand would chase you.
Yeah.
I didn't even see that this time.
I saw it.
Master Hand.
Yeah, I seen it.
It was also when we went to Disneyland for game days, there were multiple days.
Oh yeah.
Special events. It was Harry Potter Day at Disneyland.
Boom. Shouts out to the
Thumbs
Muggles.
Down. No thanks.
And 40s pinup day.
Which did you see that?
Thumbs in the middle.
Yeah. I saw some girls who were wearing like one piece old fashioned bathing suits and had their hair put up, and I saw a lot of dudes wearing zoot suits with fedoras. And it's like
out of shape dudes.
Yeah, and like that's not a pinup, sir.
No. I don't know. Why are dudes dressing up for that?
I would think too, if you were a dude going to pinup
day. You're not a pinup.
Mm-hmm. You're not a pinup. So I would think like I would be a soldier, somebody who was really into pinups in the 40s.
Oh, yeah,
or I would be like a greaser mechanic or a photographer.
Mauricio was taking care of that. Mauricio was a photographer.
Mm. Oh, sick. Good job, Mauricio.
Oh, yeah.
I spilled a little.
Shoots out to Mauricio.
I hardly got to see him at Game Day.
I saw him one time.
He was like a villain mysteriously like hiding in the wings.
I saw him one time.
He was in and out.
My favorite person to ride a ride with was Nick Brewer, who had never been.
Oh, yeah, his first Disney trip.
Yeah, he'd never been to Disneyland. And then we were on Pirates of the Caribbean. He liked it, whatever. But then at the end where you go up and Johnny Depp is right there going like, so skullduggery, whatever.
Yeah.
Nick is sitting to my left, which is like right to
closer
the side
to
of
Johnny.
The boat. And as we go up, Nick just sees the gold pieces or whatever laying at his feet. And he starts like reaching over like he's going to take them.
No.
And it's like, don't do that.
He told me that too. No. I saw Nick afterwards. He's like, I like Pirates of the Caribbean. I tried to steal a gold piece. And I was like, you know they'll kick you out for doing that. And he went, yeah, that's what Eric said. I have a friend who rode the, I believe it was Alice in Wonderland ride about 10, maybe even longer, 15 maybe years ago when we were in high school. Yeah. And at one point he was able to reach over and like pluck a flower out from the ride.
Uh-oh.
And he said the moment he got off the ride, security was waiting for him.
Sir.
They took the flower, escorted him out of the park. Goodbye. That was it.
Oh, fuck.
Wow.
Booted out. So it does happen.
Goodbye.
And they keep an eye out for that. It seemed like there were... Oh, we finally got to see some Disneyland gangs.
Oh, yeah. I saw two Disneyland gangs.
I didn't see a gang.
Yeah, I saw two.
I only saw one.
What? Leather... Oh, man.
God damn it.
I thought that they were there for pinup day because they look like...
Fucking yeah.
They look like... They
I saw a gang member who was actually there for Harry Potter Day.
Really?
Because he had the Deathly Hallows patch on his biker jacket.
So I saw people... Oh. I saw a couple guys hanging out together. They had leather vests, like big leather vests.
Yeah.
Heavy, real leather vests. That said Main Street Elite on the front, and then on the back it said Main Street Elite and has like Mickey Mouse on it or whatever, and then it says Social Club on the bottom.
Yeah.
Because they're fucking Social Club. Wake up, idiot.
Yeah. No, I get it. I know.
Vice did an article about Disney gangs.
Really?
So you can see some more photos there. I also saw...
How do they get in with those vests? I thought they were banning them.
They're bad-ass Social Club members, Garrett.
So they
sneak them in.
I used to sneak my bullet belt in. That's
Hell
true.
They, yeah.
I also saw someone in a denim vest.
Oh, the Hitchers.
The Hitchhikers.
Oh, that's the Haunted Mansion.
Mansion.
Yeah.
See, what I'm wondering, if Main Street has a gang, how does any other gang
get
into the park?
Yep. That's a good question.
I've seen the Warriors.
Yeah. I thought the same thing.
You can't just let somebody stroll through your territory, because then it's not your territory.
I saw the Main Street Elite over by Golden Corral. Did they have to bop their way through Frontierland down to Main Street?
Probably. Yeah.
Did they light a Molotov cocktail and throw it to cause a distraction?
I should have brought three glass bottles. Main Street Elite, come out to play.
You know what, actually,
awesome.
You look exactly like that guy.
Yeah,
you should be that guy for Halloween every year until you die.
That's the guy who gets It's the guy who gets held upside down in Commando.
Yeah.
And Schwarzenegger goes, remember when I said I'd kill you last? Yeah, you said
I lied.
And he lets him go.
That's you.
That's the same
Until
guy.
You die.
That is.
Commando's
that's awesome. That is what a rat man looks like, and I model myself very much after that. It's a mix of that rat man and Todd from Boogie Nights.
What do you do if you're a Disneyland gang? What in the Main Street crew, where we said they were?
Not have sex. That's what you do.
Okay, sure.
Not have a job because you're Disneyland every
What
day.
Do you do at Disneyland? Okay, I'm the Main Street. I'm here.
You hang out.
Yeah,
I'm gonna go get.
You hang
ice
out with
cone?
Your friends. Yeah, you go get a fucking.
Dude, you work the streets. Mm-hmm. You put the feet to the pavement. You're on every corner, keeping an eye out.
All right,
making sure justice is being served.
I heard a rumor about the Tomorrowland gang.
Mm-hmm.
Do they have a name?
I don't know.
No, I don't think so.
The Tomorrowland gang?
I don't know them.
I just heard that they give back to the community, like, you know, the Yakuza does that.
Uh-huh.
They have, like, cell phone chargers on them, so if you go out,
that's
so
nice of them. Because it's the future.
Yeah.
Huh.
Well, they're into tech and stuff. Mm-hmm.
I want to go up to a guy at Disneyland with a biker jacket on and ask if I could charge my cell phone out of his pocket.
That's what
I want to do.
That's what I read on that that Vice article. So next time you guys are at Disney, just go ask the Tomorrowland gang members.
I want to go with the Main Street Elite to an actual biker gang like bar.
No,
and
you
just
don't.
go, hey guys, we're all in a gang, right?
Oh, yeah. You want to witness an extinction.
I told you we have a bicycle gang like in San Diego that does like the same thing.
Yeah.
Where they
wear
like big leather jackets and with their big patches on
the back. You remember Mike from the Bertos?
Yeah.
He thought that they all hated him and were going to like beat him up.
I don't think they beat up anyone.
No, they're not. They're a bicycle gang.
They go get ramen in Little Italy.
A bicycle gang?
Hell yeah.
On trikes with stereos.
Welcome to it.
Oh.
So
Game Days is great.
Yeah.
No bullshit.
Game Days was really fun.
It was.
Yeah.
And
$96 to get in. It was $96.
It was.
Yep.
At Disneyland?
Yep.
Did you use our discounted link?
I didn't.
Well, that's where you fucked up.
See?
You gotta use that link next year.
Next year, check the link, get a discounted ticket.
And that wasn't for the park hopper?
Fool. Nope.
Jesus.
We will be going again next year. Internet Soldiers gang. We're gonna take over the whole park.
Whoa.
That should be our shirt.
Yep. Next year, we'll do...
It should have patches on it.
Yeah. Maybe. That's not a bad idea.
And then every time we see a gang, we'll all surround them and go, you're a long way from home.
We'll outnumber the shit.
We will outnumber them for sure that day.
If you read Mouse Tales, it's funny because in the 80s, the 70s and 80s, they had an actual problem with actual gangs actually fighting and actually killing each other.
Yeah, wow. Jesus.
So, like, in light of all that, this idea of a new generation of gangs with cell phone chargers is pretty funny.
It also says Social Club, and it just strikes me as guys who really like Sons of Anarchy. But, like, they're like, I'll be in a social club.
Ew.
You like that show?
Yeah, that show sucks, dude.
I've seen it. Oh.
That guy that would go do that is just gross.
Oh, that guy.
I saw the first three seasons. I thought it was okay.
That's a lot of seasons.
Well, I really like Seinfeld, and that's why I'm just a cool guy who's really funny.
I'm in a biker gang.
Don't
I'm sorry, a social club. I wear rings and have tattoos.
I also grew up, I really like Caroline in the City, and that's why I draw such good drawings.
Was her friend gay or not?
He was in love with her.
Yeah.
The guy?
Yeah. But he was also gay.
Oh.
It's conflicted.
Oh.
Interesting. I actually don't remember. That's a good question, because I know who you're talking about, but I was too young to even perceive any of that.
But I remember it.
Hmm.
Did you watch Mad About You? Very thoughtful.
No.
I did watch Mad About You.
Mad About You was
I hated that show.
I watched that show. Yeah, it was my favorite.
I liked Wings.
I liked Wings.
Oh, yeah. I was a Wings fan.
The Airport.
I was a Wingsman.
Mm. Yeah, I think that was Frasier. USA.
I like Frasier a lot.
It was, USA played it like reruns in the morning.
Yeah.
So Game Days was great.
It was a great Game Days.
I think that about wraps up our Game Days discussion, unless there's anything you guys would like to add.
Hope everyone comes out again next year. I want to make that first day even bigger and better. It went for like 5 or 6 hours.
Yeah, it was...
It did. Yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Getting back to Game Grumps, this was an experimental year for us. This was our 5th year doing Game Days, but we'd never invited another group to come and join us in our adventure. So we recently partnered up with Game Grumps to do Table Flip and some crossover videos. And kind of coming off those meetings and that established friendship was right around the time when we were beginning the preparations for Game Days. So we invited them to come along. Yeah. And
they love Disneyland too. So they
love Disneyland.
About it, yeah.
But it was an experiment, and like I said, I think it went really well. I feel like the people who were there, they did enjoy Game Grumps and their presentation.
Yeah, I was stoked. I saw a lot of people with Game Grumps t-shirts on that came into our panel and stuff.
It was cool. So next year, I definitely think we're going to try to get some more groups to come and join us, expand the event, make it a little bit bigger and better. Hopefully, it just keeps on growing in perpetuity, which means forever.
Damn.
So you just got
it was really cool just to see everyone. Like, you know, we see about conventions a lot, but we were seeing everyone at one place. You know, like, it's Jake or Steve, Stevie B, or, you know, people like all over the world. Royce. It was really cool to see everyone. Yeah. It was really neat.
But there was, like, not enough time to get to everyone.
That was
the thing.
There's not. There's I said, like, three things to Royce, and that was it. I know. I was too busy.
I really like going there, too, because it's kind of nostalgic. Like, that's where I went to college, so going back to that area and everything is always really fun to me.
When you were in college?
Because I only go once a year.
Did you party hardy when you were in college?
Yeah. It's still kind of carried over, brother.
Oh, hell yeah.
Too sweet me. That was almost it.
Cool! So, that is that. And we have officially run out of topics to talk about.
Well, we're out.
Anyone play any games?
Yeah.
What have you been playing, Garrett?